The finite impulse response, FIR filter, is the cornerstone of digital audio processing. In this short video, you will learn how to implement it in code. Hi everyone, this is Jan Wilczek from thewolfsound.com, and if you're new to this channel, I teach you how to process sound using self-written software. One of the basic sound processing operations is finite impulse response, FIR filtering. It involves passing a digital signal through a filter described by its impulse response, a finite vector of coefficients. The output of the FIR filter is the convolution of the input with the filter's impulse response. Whatever you put into the filter at any given point in time always gets transformed the same way. Mathematically, convolution is defined as an infinite sum where x is the input signal, h is the impulse response, and y is the output signal. Just as a side note, if you're interested in finding more about the convolution, I have a whole series of videos on this topic. I have linked to them in the description below. The convolution formula involves inverting one of the signals in time, shifting it in time, and then calculating an inner product of the resulting vectors. As you may imagine, infinite sums are not very practical for implementation. Neither is inverting a signal in time. For these reasons, we'll rewrite the convolution formula to be a little bit more practical. As you can see, here we have a finite sum. We know that the impulse response is finite, and without a loss of generality, we can treat the input signal as finite as well. Additionally, we have already reversed the time flow of the h coefficients, and we named them c. As you can see, each output sample can now be calculated as a simple inner product of correctly shifted and zero-padded vectors. So assuming that the filter has n coefficients, we need to append n-1 zeros at the end of the input signal. We can also insert zeros at the beginning of the input signal. Here's where the three modes of convolution come into play. If we don't insert any zeros at the beginning of the input signal and use this formula, we'll end up in the same mode of convolution. So the output will have the same number of samples as the input. If, however, we insert n-1 zeros at the beginning of x, we'll get the full mode of convolution, which is fully equivalent to the infinite sum definition we had before. So same is just a trimmed version of full. If you're interested in the modes of convolution, I have also got a video about this, and again, it is linked to in the description below. With this formula, we can already implement our filter. But before we do that, I want you to implement something else. Please subscribe to this channel, hit the thumbs up, and possibly turn on notifications. That will enable fellow audio programmers to discover these videos, even if my marketing efforts fail. Thank you. I really appreciate your vote for this content. And now to the implementation. I will be using a C++ implementation, which can be used in C after some tweaks. We will also skip the zero padding and coefficients reversal code. So first, let's define our input to the filtering function. We'll assume that it's a struct and we'll call it filter input. And here we have the input signal. We need to have its length. Then we have the reversed filter coefficients. And then we have an array for the output. So here, the output length will probably be the same as the input length. And depending on whether the x has n-1 zeros padded at the beginning, we'll get the same or full mode of convolution. Remember that x needs to have n-1 zeros, where n is the filter's length, appended at the end for this implementation to work. We assume that the three arrays are allocated and X and C are properly initialized? Y does not need to be initialized. And also the variables which tell us the length of the arrays also contain correct values. So now to the filtering function. To make the code a little bit more readable, we'll define some helper variables. And now to the implementation of the actual filtering, so the inner product between the input signal and the reversed filter coefficients. First, we need to write an outer loop where we iterate over output samples. We start each outer loop by zeroing the y coefficient. And now we need to write the inner loop, so the actual inner product for one sample. So as you can see, in each inner loop iteration, we increase the output sample by one element of the inner product sum. In other words, in our formulation, one element of the convolutional sum. The last thing that we need to do here is to return the output array. And that's it. That are C++ implementation of a plain FIR filter. Remember to always test your code. After implementing a plain FIR filter, I ran it on a simple example. I found an impulse response of a large room. I took a synthesizer recording. And then I filtered the recording using the impulse response. That's the effect. I have linked to the full code of the filter and the filtering example in the description below. In summary, in this video, we learned about an FIR filter implementation. We discussed what is an FIR filter, how can we rewrite the operation of convolution for practical implementation, and then we implemented the filtering in plain C code. We also said how to achieve various modes of convolution with this implementation by adequately zero-padding the input signal. If you found this video useful, please consider buying me a coffee at buymeacoffee.com/JanWilczek. I invite you to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this one. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Take care.